Yes, people, what's going on? Miami Dolphins lose 23-31 against the Seattle Seahawks. And I'm depleted. I'm not going to lie, I'm depleted. It's... What's the best way to describe it? I mean, oh, God. The game's literally just finished. And I'm depleted, yes. I'm proud at the same time, yes. I said I did a live stream for it. And I said really early on, I said this would be an absolutely fantastic result if the Miami Dolphins can lose by a score. And we were not a million miles away from that. It was the maximum pretty much that you could be, you know, it's with a 2-point conversion. You lose by 8 points, you know, we did have an opportunity to go and do it. But it's just individual errors. It's like I'm saying the same thing with Chelsea and with bloody the Miami Dolphins and everything. It's just individual errors. I can't run you through the Miami Dolphins touchdowns because they're only one, Fitzpatrick. But we score 15 points, 5 drives in a row, we score field goals. Which is fine. I'm happy with that. Obviously, I'd prefer us to tick over than not do anything. But the fact of the matter is that you don't win games by continuously scoring field goals. You keep yourself in them. That's fine. You keep yourself in games. But it's just annoying. You know, it's just annoying. How's the best way to describe it? You know, it's honestly, it's a real kind of like, pardon my language, it's a real clusterfuck of emotions is what's going on. You know, I'm really happy that we've actually held our own against one of the best teams in the league and a genuine Super Bowl contender in Seattle. But realistically, the Miami Dolphins threw away this game in spells. You know, we allowed a drive of 29 seconds. They travelled something like 78 yards. You know, that's ridiculous. It's ridiculous. We play really well. We keep ourselves in the game. And Seattle, this was not their best game at all. And a lot of people had them absolutely annihilating us. But we kept in the game. And one of the main things we did that I was really positive about is we kept the ball. We kept driving it down. But all we were doing is we were wasting a shed load of time for them, yes, but also ourselves in the same instance. Because we go drive all the way up. We were on their 9-yard line. And we kick a field goal. And we kick a field goal from the 9-yard line. And I'm looking at it really thinking, why would you not go for it and try and, like, you know, they're going to be backed up anyway. If you're short, you're short. But gamble on it. You know, give it a go. Not a lot of people expected the Dolphins to be in this game. So the fact that we were for such a long period of time, keep yourselves in the game, lads. You know, they go from one end of the pitch to the other in all of 29 seconds or whatever it was. And it's a joke. You know, it's a joke. It's inexcusable. But, oh, God, honestly, this is so infuriating. So infuriating. We played really well at times. We played really, really well. And then our defence, they were brilliant. They showed up in moments. They showed up in elements. And I was like, go on, lads, you know, get at them. This is against one of the best teams in the NFL. And then 5 seconds later, they'll go and do something ridiculous. Give out, you know, a stupid penalty. The run game. Oh, my God. I was really happy with Gaskin. I was really happy on our point of view from the run game. Like, Fitzpatrick's always going to run the ball, of course. He got our rushing touchdown, obviously. But we cannot block the run. We can't stop it at all. We can't. And this is the difference that we've got. You know, we've got Gaskin, who's a decent running back, to be fair. But Howard hasn't done anything. Breeder hasn't done anything. And I'll throw it back. You know, some of the offensive line play was really good. Some of it, we gave away penalties. You know, it was a holding call every now and again. There was one that I remember, Preston Williams. He got flagged for a hit against him. But of course, we held back further on, so it got changed round and he offset, and we had to replay it. You kind of just little things like that. If you don't make those mistakes on the offensive line, fine, okay, that's fine. I can deal with it. It's all right. But what I don't get is we have not got, and we haven't had for a long, long time, a really, really elite run game. Like, one person, you hand the ball off to him every single time. There you go, mate. You bugger off now. You go and do what you need to do. We haven't had that for ages. We haven't had that for a long, long time. And I look at all the players that were available in the draft. I look at all the players that were available in the draft. you know, we pick up Noah Igbinoghene. I mean, good player. Like him. Fair enough. I do like him. He's going to be a real star. Fair enough. Is it going to be at the Miami Dolphins, or is he going to be the kind of player that gets traded on elsewhere? You don't know. If you take a running back, like Saquon Barkley, obviously he was taken very high up and whatever. But you look at CeeDee Lamb, obviously wide receiver, has done absolute bits so far. Ruggs is starting to, you know, really turn a corner and whatever. At a rookie level, we really could have gone and got a first round running back. We really, really could. It was on the cards. Not even if you take a first round, but we had an early pick in the second round as well. And you're just thinking the run game was good, but we exerted a lot of energy to beat what was a very depleted Seattle Seahawks defense. And that needs to change. That really needs to change. And again, this is all kind, yeah, chill, whatever. We still got a lot of work on defense. We brought a lot of money in on defense, to be fair. And of course, Jones being out is still obviously massive, and you're going to have a lot of success and whatever. But some of the routes that Metcalf was running, I mean, you just had no hope. You had no hope. Plus, you're against one of the best in the league at quarterback, Russell Wilson. But if we go actually and be aggressive in this game, and I'm English, the Premier League, Aston Villa, a team that almost got relegated last season, have just gone and beaten the champions, Liverpool, 7-2, which is an absolutely incredible scoreline. If you're aggressive, you can achieve a lot. And we were aggressive in certain areas. And then just like that, we just let moments just fade us by, just disappear. It needs to be aggressive right the way through. And I get that we're building the trenches, and hopefully in the draft this year, we're going to be a little bit more aggressive. But there's a lot of skill players that were available in the draft just gone. And as much as I'm happy that we've built the trenches, I really am chilled that we've built the trenches. You would also have liked at the same time to go, oh, maybe you go for a skill player. Maybe you go for, of course, we got Tua, but you go for a running back. You go for someone like that. Someone that you know that you can put the ball onto, you know, 20 times in a game kind of thing. Maybe not 20 times, but you know what I mean. You can just go, there you are, mate. You bugger off. And it just winds the clock down, but it does it in your favour. Every time we threw the ball, it seems like it had to be absolutely perfect. To be fair, I'm happy with Fitz. Obviously, he is a great player. He is what he is at the moment. He's filling in for Tua pretty much until Tua gets ready to go in a very tough season for us, unfortunately. But there were just so many things. I'm kind of rambling on a bit, and I'm going to kind of round this off. There were so many different things that we had in our control and was in our possession, and we could genuinely have impacted the game in a better, and even if we'd have lost by 4 points, I wouldn't be sitting here doing this. But we've lost by 8. That is more than a score, unfortunately. It's really infuriating. It's really infuriating. I'm going to finish it off on this. Dolphins, if we keep in the game for longer, we're fine. But there was a good spell in there where we were 15 points behind, something like that. We did well to stop that from happening bang after half time. We did very well, actually. In fact, of course, we picked off Russell Wilson. Well done, Xavier Howard, on that. But if you have Jones and Howard fit, then that, you know, you can maybe have some more success there. Fine. But actually, at the same time, we allowed them to have the possession when they did. They didn't have a lot of it, but when they did, they made the most of it, especially in the second half. We kept ourselves in the game for the whole of the first half, so worked really, really hard. And then just like that, we switch off in moments and all our hard work's gone. Can't do it every week, do you know what I mean? You can't do it every week. And you won't play Russell Wilson every week, and this will hopefully get better. I just want to see the Dolphins be a little bit more aggressive at times. We're not going to make the playoffs, probably not. We are better than a 3-1 team. A 3-1, oh, I wish a 3-1 team. A 1-3 team. We are better than that, that's fine. We have played some really good opposition in the last few days, few weeks. But it's got to stop. It's got to stop. We're good, fine, woohoo, great, but we can't afford to do that every week. So anyway, thanks for watching. If you're new around here, make sure you like, share and subscribe. I'm going to go and enjoy my Sunday night and watch some other stuff, and hope my fantasy team does something. But anyway, take care, stay safe. Make sure you subscribe to Craigo28Sport, and I'll see you back here for loads more Finns content.